All right, Libra, Astro Lectures, episode 5. It's after 3 a.m. in the morning. Still up, so time to deliver some messages. Been seeing synchronicities for the past 6 hours. All up in my face. Where is my candle? Oh, there you go. It'll be recreational, right? Candle burnout, use it as an incense holder. Trying to make solving issues so difficult. And it could all be so simple. But yeah, it seems like your energy is pretty clear. Astro lectures have been coming along. I wanted to do Aries, Libra, a few, all of them at once. So I think I left off with Aries. So yeah, we have Libra. And then next, I believe we'll be doing... Who's next? I got Pisces. Huh, I guess we'll see. It is the way of the Libra, right? Looking over contracts, details, balancing things and communicating with others. Could be taking on new acquaintances at this time. Be what? Expansion? Alright. See what's grounding your reading today. For your fifth astro lecture, Libra. Angels, ancestors, spirit guides. What are the messages for the Libra Collective today? Astro lecture episode 5. What are the messages, angels and ancestors? Alright. Six of Swords. Leaving a toxic situation or leaving toxic thought patterns. Coming out of difficult situations. Restlessness. Let's get into the reading. Angels, ancestors, what messages do we have for the collective today? Queen of Pentacles. Could be dealing with an earth sign or working on your finances at this time. You're actually onto something pretty big at this time. Queen of Pentacles symbolizes the monarch. So this is like wisdom of your forefathers. This is like wisdom from your, I guess, foremothers, right? Yeah. Or your four brothers. That's an interesting message. Because it's like we have distant relatives, like second cousins and third cousins and aunties. And what do you call your grandfather's brother? Grand uncle? Grand auntie? So wisdom is being cultivated and passed through the generations at this time. Passed through. It's like someone's passing. It could be mediumship. It is 3 a.m. This is the witching hour. This could be mediumship, and I do kind of have like mediumship abilities as well. So this could be some form of a spirit or a soul passing through the afterlife at this time or coming out of difficult situations. But this is ancestral knowledge. It could seem like a burden at this time as well. At 21 years old, we go through a sort of spiritual death. The symbolization there is 3. And then at 33 again, you go through the ego death, which is similar to Christ himself. So you could be approaching your ego death. I mean, it doesn't take for you to have to go to be 33 years old. It can happen at any point in life. You hit your spiritual transformation or your spiritual expansion. It's basically you becoming more mindful and becoming more aware of the effect that you have on the world, and taking accountability and accepting your place in the cosmos. So this is great enlightenment at this time, Libra. Great strength at this time with the strength card. could have dealings with the Leo, or you could be exuding great bravery at this time. You don't necessarily have to be a Leo or have any type of Leo personalities around you. You could just be embodying this energy. Again, energy is interchangeable. It doesn't get destroyed. It just get transferred from one place to another. You do battle with people, you take their confidence. That's their ego death, and you become more powerful. But this is also your ancestors as well. Strength is strength through the ages, strength through the years, strength through the family, strength throughout the bloodlines. Yeah, your ancestors are calling you to standing your truest authentic power. They had to bring you to this point so you can realize how strong you are with the strength card. I was just watching some old clips of The Lion King, part where Rafiki took Simba to the pond and he looked himself in the reflection of the pond and he saw his father. But yeah, this is ancient wisdom, everything pretty much. This is very powerful downloads. And again, this is raising people from the dead. You may be a motivational speaker or some type of tarot reader, a doctor, any type of healer. You're raising the dead. All these people were laying down in a graveyard in their coffin, lifeless. And you're blowing your horn, or you're using your instrument or your knowledge, and you're calling judgment on the situation, or your ancestors and your angels are calling judgment on the situation for you to rise up. This is your tribe. This is your cult or your family or strong brotherhood as well. Very strong brotherhood. Again, it's like you had to take you to this point to where you become completely loyal, and you know that you have to lay down your life for the things that you believe in or the things that your ancestors hold important. It's like they had this planned out. Queen of Pentacles. Yeah. You've been working on your grounding, Libra. You've been too aloof. This could be you being lazy or saving at this time. I equate them to being the same. My life. What else do we have here? Capricorn. We have Taurus, we have Virgo, we have Leo. Major Arcana Judgment and Strength coming out as well. The Four of Pentacles. Again, that's your stability. You've received a lot of downloads. You see the downloads coming on up at the top, at the crown. You started to realize your truth, your power. The pentacle is at the center, which is the solar plexus, your confidence. You're standing, you're finding the things in your life that you want to stand on, which is your truth. You're taking the time to evaluate those things at the Four Pentacles. More messages, Ace of Wands. You consider this a horny moment. Very creative. Putting that sexual energy into your creative passions. This could be painting. This could be art. This could be adventure. This could be gym routines. This could be acting. Aces are new opportunities coming in. Experiencing something new. Or getting a chance to experience something new. Wands are about our spirituality, our creativity, our spontaneity. Dealing with a fire sign here. Major fire aspects here with the Strength card and the Ace of Wands coming out here. So Libra, we know adding fire to air creates a tornado, right? So be very careful with the energies that you're dabbling in. See what I'm telling you? The forecast is coming in heavy. We have Devil Energy, Capricorn. Major Arcana here. Could be Toxicity. This is... This is almost forbidden knowledge here. I would say almost forbidden knowledge because it's perspective. When certain groups of people wanted to enslave other groups of people, they did it with religion. And then when those people started to use their own very own religion that they remember from their ancestors, the people that were trying to enslave them with their religion started to call their religion evil. Things like voodoo. We used to grow up and people used to tell us things like, oh, voodoo was evil. Well, indeed, that's ancient African culture. That's like the closest thing that we have. All those islanders down there is the closest thing that we have to the original people. But yeah, that you'll hear stories like that and people will make you think that it's all a system of control, really. We have the Queen of Pentacles here, the Matriarch, which is a system of control. People will try to control you. But death, you could be experiencing some type of death spiritually, physically, or mentally. Seems more spiritual. There's a spiritual death here. Could be literal, depending on the story. Multiple situations here. Libra's always in something. You have the power to change the outcomes of these situations. The scales tip in your balance. Well, you are the scales. And hence, we have balancing here to do with all these options here. Seven of Cups. Maybe someone is viewing you as their Seven of Cups. They don't know what to do with you. Balance. Seems like they want to connect with you. They want to seek balance with you. This could be a business partnership or some type of a relationship. I don't see love coming up in this reading. So it's some type of this is some type of counterpart. This is some type of soulmate. Is this a karmic? Ace of Cups. This is a new karmic. This is a relationship that is destined to happen. These things are meant to teach you something new. Aces are new opportunities. Cups are new love. Or it could be a gift. Some form of emotional stability. Oh man, we're going to have to come up with some new terms here. So we have Ace of Wands and Ace of Cups coming up. But this is a very good opportunity to expand your spirituality, expand what your true heart's desire. What in the world? I think it's the devil energy coming up here. It's 3 a.m. It's the witching hour. Be careful with the things that you're wishing for and the things that you're hoping for. Like, you want money, you have to be specific about these things. Again, I bring up movie references. There was the movie Leprechaun, where the man wished for riches, and the leprechaun put the freaking pot of gold in his stomach. So you have to be very careful when you're messing with earthly energy. See, there's a reason why the government tries to keep the masses ignorant. Because people get power, and people get knowledge, and they just start throwing it around. And then when people start looking in their closets and find the things that they've been doing behind closed doors, a lot comes crashing down. Hence, we have this balancing act that's taking place here. And you needing to rise above and show strength in yourself. Bring balance and bring judgment. everything doesn't, the weight of the world does not fall on you, but you have to show confidence in yourself as well. It's almost like the devil picks and chooses people that he wants to bully in the 3D realm, because he know that they don't have the higher knowledge or the higher power of protection in the 3D realm unless they are very, really, unless they on some BS, because they don't really need to mess with those people that's already on some BS. So, how long have we been going with this reading, Libra? We're on going on 16 minutes. I'll finish pulling some messages here for your astral lecture episode 5. I don't know why it took me so long to do this reading, and I'm doing it in the middle of the night during the witching hour after seeing so many synchronicities. And this reading is in, it seems like it's in regards to spirituality. Bearing witness to, so it's going to be front and center, right in your face. You're going to witness it first person. The things that people do and the things that people say, it's like you're witnessing. I mean, that's martyrism again. You're witnessing it. We have, I think this is the Lover's card. This is a twin flame union. We have the Devil. I was just explaining this card. Oh, this is the Two of Cups. It's still a twin flame union. This is like the minor arcana version of the Lovers. But this is a twin flame. So you two are two immature personalities, it seemed like. Or this love or this spirituality or this connection starts off very immature. It has not evolved yet. It's not like two old people. It's like still two young people. They're still learning themselves. And that's why there's still karmic energy attached to this. That's why there's still karmic energy attached. Man, I don't know how long this is going to be. And it's going to be an interesting relationship. I'm not sure if you can avoid it either. Yeah, man. So definitely hope you enjoyed the reading today. Just trying to see if I can pull any additional messages. Yeah, definitely more synchros. Two of Cups. Two of Pentacles. Balance. Coordination. Four. That's structure. Grounding. You have three major arcana: Judgment, the Devil, and showing strength in a situation. Again, you could be dealing with a Capricorn or a Leo. I'm not sure what Judgment is. But this is very powerful energy here. Ace of Wands, Ace of Cups. New relationship coming in here. Again, it's almost like an unavoidable partnership. You guys are probably going to hate each other at some point. But that's the way love goes. That's the way. That's the way. There's going to be a lot of spiritual downloads. You guys are going to bring, yeah, there's going to be a lot of abundance here as well. The foundation, there's a throne here. It's not a regular chair. What else do we have here? That's it. That's the rest of the cards. And we have the Ten of Swords. That's the anxiety that's going to be brought to this relationship for whatever reason. Or the amount of spiritual attacks that's what it is. People are going to be hating. There's going to be spiritual attacks thrown at you. People are going to be trying to threaten your legacy before you have a chance to finish it. Before you have the chance to finish it. Wow, that's some very powerful messages, Libra. Stay protected, stay divinely guided. I'm very sure that I don't have to tell you to use your discernment. Reach out to my social media handles, OU Lucy, on TikTok and Instagram. For any spiritual coaching, email me at antwill1016@gmail.com. Other than that, you guys be safe out there, Libras.